Welcome back to the show.
How about that? We've got a future sports report broadcaster, Taylor Washington, Destiny McDonald on the end, and Mitz Halliday, Lima senior girls basketball coach. Just four games left. We're into February, and that means we're nearing the end of the regular season. Coach, second place in the track right now. How do you feel your team's played to this point?
Oh, no, I think we're right at the high. We set high expectations for ourselves, and we're right there. We got four more to go, and they're all league games, so we need to finish the deal. But if we could go 12-2 in our league and only lose to Notre Dame Academy, that'd be a really good season.
Yeah, no question about it. 13-5 overall. What have been some of the monumental points in your season to get you to where you're at right now?
Oh, I'm not sure. We've played well, solid, consistently all season long. First game of the year, like to have that one back. But the other four losses, twice to Notre Dame, Liberty Benton, and OG.
Yeah, pretty good
those
teams.
Those are all state-ranked teams. They're all really good. They're all going to have a great postseason run. So there's nothing to be ashamed of there. We just need to kind of, like I said earlier, we just kind of finish what we started here. And I know that these teams are all looking to get a crack at us because we beat them the first time around in league play. So we need to tighten up a little bit, but I think we can get it done.
Tomorrow, taking on Whitmer, and then three more games before they finish out with Clay on Valentine's Day, Senior Day. And speaking of those seniors, tell us about these two ladies and what they've meant to your program.
Oh, these two are fantastic. On the way over, we talked about, I brought them here when they were super sophomores a couple years ago. They've been fantastic. Destiny, kind of been our leading scorer, our best defensive player all season long, our leader in that aspect on the floor. Taylor's our vocal leader. She knows every position. She knows everyone's supposed to be. She's very positive and helps everyone out, coaching on the floor because she's the most verbal player that we have. And they've set the tone for us all year. And as a coach, you kind of always say you're as good as your senior class. And these two have really gotten it done for us.
Taylor, what is it about being a vocal leader that you've enjoyed this season and that you'll continue to enjoy here?
I think it's because I want to be a coach that I kind of take on that role on the floor. And he says all the same things all the time, so it's like I know what he's going to say and when he's going to say it. So if I tell them before he says it, we'll all be good.
That's awesome. You want to be a coach? Is that what you're going to kind of go towards?
Yes, athletic director, coaching, something of that nature. I want to be in the school with sports.
Very nice, very nice. Destiny, senior year, what's this felt like for you? It's finally here. You've been playing for so many years.
it's amazing. Playing with the team that we have is – energy, positive. I love my team.
Yeah. Notre Dame Academy, obviously one of the best teams in the state, perhaps the best team in the state. They're in the track as well. You get to go up against them twice each year.
Yep.
What's it like having that kind of competition?
Well, honestly, it seems a little unfair at times because they're so good.
Right.
And they just keep, getting a new player every year, reloading every year. And when you get the opportunity to get the best players from the Toledo area and parts of Michigan, that helps. You know what I mean? And I've always kind of joked if I could get, all the best players from the Lima area, I'd feel really good about my chances against them. But that's not the case. You set a goal to win the league, and that's not going to work out because they're loaded once again. But our goal is to get back to that district final, get a third opportunity to play them. And I like to think maybe we can get, one trick up our sleeve and get them that third time around. So that's the objective.
Speaking of that district final, tournament draws this Sunday for the ladies. Balloting's done right now. Is it done by Friday?
It goes through today.
Okay.
They're just basically letting you vote late tomorrow night into Sunday morning.
Oh, okay, okay.
So we have to get everything established. I've already got, I filled out my ballot or whatever, but we don't actually vote until later tomorrow night or Sunday morning before the meeting there.
Gotcha. So. Always exciting to see where other schools put you and get your draw.
Yeah, absolutely. I think Notre Dame Academy is the number one team. Sylvania Southview's two.
Okay.
I like to think we could be in that mix for the third seed between ourselves, Perrysburg, maybe even Whitmer. And Northview is also in that mix as well. So if we could get high as third, maybe as low as fifth or sixth, but obviously, the objective will be, and again, the opposite half of the draw, Notre Dame, take care of business there, and hopefully we can meet up with them one more time.
And you have a feeling a lot of schools are going to try and go to the other
side. Oh, sure, absolutely. I think Notre Dame's going to pick a line, and then probably the next four or five schools are going to go on the opposite half.
Yeah, definitely. Taylor Washington has given us time cues from my camera operator over here. So not only a great coach in basketball, but also here on the TV set as well. Favorite memory, looking back thus far, playing as a Lima senior?
All 4 years or this year?
Sure, all four.
I think being a freshman and being able to play with Rion and Essence, because like I kind of always looked up to them, and them being able to tell me what I was doing wrong, what I was doing right, and trusting me to, when they leave, take over the team. I think that was a good memory. And beating OG, that was a number. They was ranked third in the state, so that was a great memory.
Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah.
No question. Those things stick out for sure. As we get ready for four more games for the Lima senior girls basketball team in the regular season and then postseason play, they will head north. Faustoria, is that one of the sectionals?
Yeah, Faustoria or Start.
Or Start. Okay. Yep. So chance to see the Spartans at home February the 14th in their final home game, and then on the road as well coming up. As we look forward to graduation, you ladies excited for that, or is it too far away? You're still in basketball
it's
mode.
It's not too far. No, it's far. Ready. It's yeah. too. It's.
They're ready.
It needs to be now.
Destiny.
Yeah. I'm in between still.
She probably want to play a couple more games.
right. Lots of excitement for Lima senior, and also I understand I'm excited for the TJ's Pizza that you will be able to get some after this interview. We're going to do the interview first. But then you're going to – who can eat the most pizza on the team?
Oh, that'd be
besides
me.
The coach.
Oh, yeah. That's
he orders his own pizza.
And then you guys get another one?
He eats his own separate pizza. We share as a team. Okay. We share.
Because sharing is caring.
Yes, it is.
It's very good. Lima senior girls basketball. Thanks for stopping by. We'll go get that TJ's Pizza. Patrick and Frank with more on Sports Report coming up.